Hello everybody. I'm glad to be here, but I must tell you that I was thrown in with rather short notice, so I haven't been able to prepare too much about this. Eva and I, we were supposed to share this presentation, but unfortunately she has taken ill, so I'm here alone. And I will try to present a little bit about our thinking in Södertälje. A few words about the town. It's not as big as Uppsala. We have around 87,000 inhabitants in Södertälje. But in fact, it is the most important town in Sweden. For a reason. Because we have two very big industries. We have Scania, as you maybe know, they manufacture buses and lorries. And we have AstraZeneca. They manufacture medicines of different kinds. And those two industries together, they are in fact providing Sweden with around 25% of the net income of all exportation in Sweden. And no other city in Sweden can match that. So that's why Södertälje is so important for the Swedish economy. Unfortunately, we don't get so much of those that money ourselves, so we can't build podcast systems as we might have been able to do otherwise. Anyway, we have, as Uppsala and many other towns, cities in Sweden, been thinking for quite some years about building a podcast system. I will present our thoughts. However, we have presently a rather blocked situation. We haven't been able to finance this ourselves, and we have a political situation in Södertälje where it's not quite clear what the different political parties think about this. So what I will present to you is, investigations and thoughts that we produced around 2-3 years ago, and since then not much has happened, unfortunately.
Just personally entered.
Well, why do we want to do this? Yes, of course, we have the same problem as almost all cities in Sweden. We have too much cars, too little public transport. And in fact, situation in Södertälje is worse than in many other cities because we have a very, very high share of transport by passenger cars and very small share by public transport. And we have an environmental problem with that, of course. We have a big problem with air pollution, more than expected relatively to the size of the town. We have too much carbon dioxide emissions. We, as Uppsala, we would like to have the city carbon dioxide neutral. The organization, the community organization, is almost there. We have reduced our carbon dioxide emissions with around 70% in the last 10-15 years. And we have the same goal as Uppsala. We would like to have the organization to be carbon dioxide neutral. And the whole town, the whole city, well, that might take a little bit longer time. But one important step to do that is, of course, to reduce the use of passenger cars. We don't think that alternative fuels can replace today's fossil fuels, at least not with the present volumes of transportation, and we expect those to rise, so this is a difficult situation. And we also have a rather bad problem with particles from passenger cars in the middle of the town, and we have to do something about that. So the way is, of course, electric transportation. Public transport run by electricity. We have goals in our traffic planning. We must reduce the traffic in the city center. We need to have more cyclists than pedestrians. We want to increase the market for public transport, and we need to cut both noise and emissions. Those are important political goals, and not any of the political parties have anything to say about that. They may have varying opinion of how it can be reached, but we all agree that this has to be done. So, to investigate possibilities, About 3 years ago, we made a couple of podcast investigations in Södertälje that we published, and I think that those of you who were present in San Jose, I wasn't able to be there myself, but a former colleague presented a couple of these results in a speech at that time, and we did the same the year before in Malmö. So maybe this is not new to all of you, but hopefully you get some kind of new information anyway. We have developed an urban development strategy. You could say that Södertälje is a number of rather small islands that are not too much connected with each other. And we would like to connect these islands together, as you can see in the left part of this picture. And we also would like to connect both housing, jobs, public transport, railway stations, etc. via some kind of good new network. We developed a vision of a future podcar network that would fulfill both of these aims, to connect different parts of the town and also connect jobs, housing, public transport, railway transportation and so on. And that vision, you can see it here in red, it's a rather extensive network. Of course, we don't dare to hope that we can build all this at the same time. We have to start somewhere. And one step towards this goal is that next year we'll create a new line network of buses, main bus lines. They will partly go in the same directions as the podcast system that you saw on the last slide. And they will be quick, frequent. You don't need a timetable. You can just go to the stop and wait for the next bus. It will come in only a few minutes. And we think that could be some kind of interesting preparation for a future podcast system. We have had a lot of discussions about podcasts in the city center. Some political parties don't like the idea that podcasts can go through the city streets, pass by people's bedrooms and so on. They, for some reason, they don't like to think that the podcast should be running 5 meters up in the air, passing people's homes. We may have a solution to that, but we at least have suggested this pilot line in the city center, where we have a lot of target groups. Of course, we'd like to have introduction of park and ride, and we would like to attract park and ride passengers, a lot of other kinds of commuters, people living in the city centers, people visiting the city center for shopping, other reasons of course. And the main target points will be the pedestrian street, university campus. We have an important attraction, Tom Tits exhibition in the middle of the city. The industries, AstraZeneca and also Scania, and City Hall and the railway and bus station. Facts about this suggested line is a little less than 5 kilometers long, 8 stations. It will run in a loop, sort of 8. We will have a depot in the south part, where we today have a parking space. We calculate with a little less than 500 trips in the peak hour, and altogether around 4,000 trips every day. The cost would be, according to our calculations, around 380 million Swedish crowns. I think that would be a little more than 400 in today's money value, and 9 million per year at costs. We, as all communities in the Stockholm area, expect a growth in habitation. The Stockholm area, we expect that it will grow with perhaps a couple of 100,000 people in the coming 10-15 years. And that will be shared, of course, with all the communities around the city. In Södertälje, we expect that we have to build around 1,400 new apartments. And we need to develop the industry and the marketing. So we need perhaps 10,000 square meters of retail space in the coming 20 years. That's a lot, and of course we need good public transport to be able to fulfill the needs of both inhabitants and the people doing business. So in our opinion, the podcast is a transport system with very many great advantages. It will strengthen our environmental profile, which is rather strong already today. We are, according to rankings, number 9 in Sweden totally. And in the Stockholm area, we are the best environmental community of all. We know that podcasts will increase that profile substantially. And we also know that if we introduce podcasts, we will have less need for parking, less traffic in the city center. We can also integrate the lines in houses, in commercial properties. And we can increase the availability for the city center for anybody. And as I said earlier, we can connect different facilities, park and ride, rail station, housing, jobs and trade centers. Financing, of course. We were, as all these communities in Sweden who participated in the contest a couple of years ago, expected to get some contribution from the government. But we can see now that this is not going to happen, so we have to do this financing by ourselves. And possibilities that we have not investigated thoroughly yet, we will do that in the future. But of course, property owners, developers of the housing and marketing areas, the university campus, the Tom Tits Exhibition Center, they're both big industries, and perhaps also the podcast suppliers. We are going to talk with all of them to see if we can get some kind of interest in taking part in the financing. We also think that it's important to start somewhere. It may be not in Södertälje, it might be in Uppsala, fine. Anywhere is a good start, because we need to have some kind of pilot line somewhere in Sweden to show that this is possible. We need to have a pilot line that really shows that podcasts are possible in an urban environment. We are happy for every kind of investment in Sweden. Hopefully it will be in Södertälje, but we will be as glad if it is in Uppsala or perhaps in Upplands Väsby. We have made our pre-planning. All the route of this pilot line in the city center is already planned, so we know exactly how it's going to work, where it will be, and so on. And we feel that we can share with you a lot of advantages, because we have, as you have already heard, a lot of target groups. We have a real city environment. We have made the pre-planning. We have integrated the line in the city planning. It will be the first part of a future public transport system. And of course it will increase our trademark. And that's actually the end of my presentation. Thank you very much.